let's try to ride a little bit more. And yeah, they said if it's really bad, you can come back. But it dries pretty quickly here, so I hope that it will dry. Oh, look at that. Wow. Beautiful birds. They're eating, I don't know what that was. So this is the road now. It's not great, but it's relatively dry. Some parts are still very slippery, but the majority is pretty okay. I can just ride this. So yeah, it's 75 kilometers to Las Flores. I was planning to ride a little bit more, but this road is taking me forever. Oh, I'm slipping and sliding again. Look at it. It's just the top is quite sandy. If you see these light patches, those are good, and the dark patches are not so good. So I'm just riding. Oh, look at those birds. Just riding in between farmlands. And I find it extremely beautiful here. There's a lot of wildlife, a lot of birds. Oh, look at that. You're so beautiful. So far the road has been pretty dry. Every now and then it's a bit sandy. But it looks like it hasn't been raining here today, so that's good. Let's see where this goes. Oh, maybe I cannot continue here, can I? I'm supposed to take a left. Yeah, I can. Oh no, it's closed. Is it? Let's check it out. Maybe I can pass, but I think... not. No, it's closed. Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame. Oh well, I'll just go back. Just have to backtrack a little bit, I think. There's birds of prey everywhere. Okay, let's take a left here. It's 50 kilometers still Las Flores. All on this type of road, so it's not bad. At all! I'm loving it! And I'm still escaping the next storm, see? Which is over there. But I think I'll be fine here. It's not moving very fast, that storm. It hasn't rained here, see? This is all dry. And this actually rides perfectly. Okay, I'm riding 80 here. So that's all fine. This is a very sandy bit again. Can you believe this? On my first ride, I have a puncture. Unbelievable! Oh, what a bad luck, hey! Alright. Well, let's change the tube then.
So yeah, it's the rear tire. It must be something big, because how else can I have a puncture? Oh, there it is. See? A nail. And it is huge! Yeah, that is the one. So, yeah. change the tube. That's the mission. I'm gonna do it. It is, what time is it? 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And, oh yeah, let's change the tube. That's all I can say. I took my luggage off, so I have some more room. And yeah, I have a spare tube with me, so yeah, change it. The tire just went flat in an instant. See, there's a rip here. So, but this is a heavy duty tire, heavy duty tube. So I'm not gonna throw it. I'm just gonna keep it and then have it fixed somewhere where they can vulcanize it. And I'm just gonna stick it in my spare tube, which is a normal one. So that's not an extra heavy duty one. And then when I have this one fixed, then I'll just put this one back. This is really thick, so it's not great to keep with you because it takes a lot of space. Alright, I just put a little bit of air in the tube with my compressor, which I'll show you later. So now I'm gonna put it in. You just have to make sure that there's a red dot here, and that's supposed to be at the red dot actually has to sit here. Carrying some dishwashing liquid that will make it easier to put the tire back. In the meantime, I hear thunder in the background, so I hope it will stay dry until I finish this. That would be nice. In the meantime, nobody has passed this road since I started. It's a super quiet road. Speaking of which, I think I felt the first drops of water, so quickly gonna work, put the tire back. Be careful not to cause a puncture. Now we're gonna put air back in the tire with the pump. So I have a wire here connected to my compressor, and now it's a matter of getting the air back in. Okay, now put it back. So now comes another difficult part, because I have to lift up the tire and at the same time push that thing through, which is not so easy. So I have this tool which will help me to keep the tire up, so I can push that one through with my other hand, because basically you're just one hand short if you're doing this. So I'm pushing this under the tire. Yes! I did it! Look, this is the result of this hard work. Woo. That did not go super easy. But I did it, so that's the main thing. Done! I think it's done.
Whew, what time is it? It is 5:40. Oh my goodness, it took me 2.5 hours. But doesn't matter. I did it. Let's try again. Through all this lovely sand to reach a town today. Let's hope I will make it before dark. That would be nice. Ah, this is better. Look at that sky, isn't it beautiful? I'm now very close to Las Flores. It's only 5 kilometers. And then I'm in Las Flores. And yeah, I can already see some more houses, some more people. So that's good news. Now I just have to find a place to stay. I have no idea where I'm gonna stay. I didn't look at Las Flores because I was planning to ride a little bit more. But I think I'll call it a day for today. So I'll see if I... yeah, I don't know if there's a hotel or a guest house or whatever in Las Flores. Let's hope so. Oh, some more sand. Oh, look, a gaucho. Oh, hi. Beautiful horse, hey, wow, amazing. Where am I gonna go? This way. Paved road, look at that. Wow, nice. No more sand or mud. Bicicletas. So maybe in this town I can even find a workshop where they can fix my tire. Oh yeah, maybe that one. Yeah, or that one. Nah, probably tomorrow I'll just go to one of those shops and then see if they can fix my tube and then put it back. Then I have my heavy duty tube in the tire and the normal one is a spare. Works good. Ah, petrol station, also good to know. Ah, this is pretty big town. So there must be a hotel somewhere here. I'm sure I can find one. Cool. Alright, I'm just gonna go back. Hello. Desculpe. Oh! Oh, lo siento, no, no sabía. Estoy buscando un hotel.
Hotel? Si tú quieres remedio al cordón. Hotel tiene uno a cada vuelta.
Ajá.
Y después tiene uno ya saliendo casi del... O sea, tiene que agarrar esta derecho.
Ajá.
Antes, se va a chocar los primeros semáforos. No, los segundos, de esta mano en la esquina, tiene uno.
Ah, ok.
Pero el más cercano...
Es más... Ah, ok. Entonces voy a...
Pega la vuelta, tiene que hacer 2 cuadras para allá.
Para... Ah, 2 cuadros.
Derecha, hace 2 cuadras para allá.
Ajá.
Dobla a su derecha.
Ah... Esta calle también es única.
Es única mano para allá.
Ah,
ok. Pega la vuelta, hace 2 cuadras para acá.
Sí.
Dobla a su derecha,
sí.
2 cuadras y retoca.
Ok,
para acá.
Ok, entiendo.
Y sale de nuevo esta avenida.
Ok, perfecto. Ok, gracias. Wow, so this was a one-way street. I kind of missed that one. Oops. Well, it happens. So, but now this is also one way, so I have to make a turn. Oh, this is also not. Oh, oops. No. No. Gracias. This one then. Ah, yeah. Yeah, I just need to look at the arrows. I've not been doing that. Well, or the parked cars, obviously. Right arrow. The touristic route of Las Flores. This one, yeah. Here, hotel. All right, they have room. Yes, yes. And also secure parking for Dano. So I'm just gonna have to bring it to the other side. Okay, so I have to go against the traffic for a little bit. Look at the dog. You see the dog out of the window? But yeah, I'll just go around the corner here, and then Dano can sit securely inside, which is nice. Okay.
And I am in my hotel room. This is my room, bathroom, pretty fine. Oh, what a day. It is now 7 o'clock in the evening, so it has been an extremely long day. I've been sweating like a maniac, yeah, I don't know, just so much happened. I mean, first that thunderstorm, getting shelter, then dropping the snow in the mud, which was, yeah, I don't know, it was inevitable with that. That mud was just so slippery, and it just made like this sort of cake around my tires, which was just all, yeah, I had no more profile basically, so I was just like, whoa. And yeah, then deciding, okay, I can ride again, it is dried up a little bit, and that was the case. And then getting a nail in the tire. So yeah, probably this will start again the whole discussion about tube tires and tubeless tires. I'm not gonna go into that discussion. I have tubes, and there's reasons why tires have tubes with spokes. So I am not gonna go into the discussion. But anyway, I think the main thing is for me is that I fixed it by myself. Took me 2.5 hours, but that didn't really matter so much. I did it, and that was the main thing, because I'd never done that before, so it was the first time that I had to do it. Yeah, especially the rear tire is a bit tricky, like especially getting the tire back. Yeah, that just took some time. But yeah, I did it, and well, I didn't really quite make it to where I was planning to go today, but I'm not too far off. I still made it to Las Flores, which is good. So, oh my goodness, oh, look at that sky. Can you see that? That pink glow over there. It's beautiful. Sorry, my hands are still really dirty. Dirty. I tried to clean them. I mean, having that dishwasher liquid is great to if you have to change a tube in your tire. But it's also great to afterwards wash your hands with it. But okay, I didn't wash it too properly. But anyway, I mean, wow, what a first day to start this adventure. I cannot believe how many things happened today. It's yeah, anyway, but yeah, I feel good. It still was a good day. I loved the ride. I mean, it was just beautiful, and I just loved riding around the countryside, and I did a lot of sand riding as well, which is also good because I'm pretty much petrified of sand and riding in sand. And I did so much riding in sand today, and it went actually pretty well. So that was also a good lesson for me. Have some more practice of riding in sand. So yeah, all in all, a really good day. A little bit exhausting, but okay. And yeah, I think tomorrow I'll go in town here and try to get my tube fixed. Yeah, and then have the heavy duty fixed tube put back in my tire. Because, well, yeah, I mean, I just got really unlucky with the nail, but the heavy duty inner tubes, they do protect you for a lot of other things, so it is better to have those. So yeah, that was my plan before I started the trip. I thought I have the heavy duty tubes in the tires. If I get a puncture, I change them for my spare one, have the heavy duty repaired, with they vulcanize it, and then put those back, and then have the other tube again as a spare. So I'm gonna stick to that strategy. So yeah, I already saw a small shop with tires outside and saying something with Moto, so I'm sure they can fix it for me. I think that's a good thing about South America. There's people on mopeds and motorbikes everywhere, which is great, because that also means that you get repair shops and tire shops everywhere, so that's really helpful. So yeah, I think I'm gonna try to do that tomorrow. Try to make this day into a video, or maybe two videos, and yeah, figure out where I'm gonna go next. So yeah, that was it for today. Welcome to the Patagonian Alaska adventure, which didn't even start yet because I'm still on my way to Patagonia. I'm not even in Patagonia at the moment, but it doesn't matter. It really started today. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and subscribe down below, and then I'll see you in the next video.